I think my biggest advice to girls who want to get into science and engineering is find other girls who want to do the same thing. But I have found throughout my life that all of the best accomplishments start with a little bit of discomfort, start with a little bit of fear that maybe you're not good enough or maybe this isn't for you, because those are going to be the situations that challenge you. Embrace the uncertainty, embrace the unknown, embrace those fears, because that is the only time that you can be brave. That's the only time that you can kind of build your skill sets and build your knowledge. I am Emily Calandrelli. When I was their age, I just assumed that I was always going to be a mediocre student. I didn't realize that if you are willing to put in the work, that you can make yourself smarter, that you can rise in the ranks. I like to tell people that in order to bridge the gap between what scientists know and what the public believes when it comes to science, is that we have to be empathetic, we have to be kind, because a lot of people who deny certain scientific truths, like, say, climate change or the safety of vaccinations, it's more than just they're stupid, right? We can't just discount these people that they're stupid. Then we'll never be able to bridge that gap. We have to understand why these people deny the science. We have to understand the reasons that led to that. And to be able to educate them, you first have to listen. You first have to really empathize with them. So this was the biggest girl-powered event, I've been told, and the audience here was just mind-blowingly amazing. You know, sometimes you don't know what to expect. Some people are really shy, they don't want to ask questions, they're maybe a little bit embarrassed or self-conscious. Not this group. They couldn't stop asking questions, and really good questions too. Things like this are so important because they are going to carry these friendships for the rest of their lives. This is going to be a very intense, awesome, exciting, memorable experience for them. I love being a science communicator in general. I'm combining this like storytelling, creative part of me with this hard science part of me. And I didn't know that that was even possible growing up. I thought you either had to be creative or you had to be in science, you know, left brain versus right brain. But I've learned that through careers like mine, I can combine those two skill sets and create an entirely new career where I get to share my passion with others every day.